Hey guys, I'm Voilin, and a little bit of a backstory about me. When I was around 12 years old, I got typing lessons. Use all your fingers and nice touch typing. However, for the past couple of years, I've been typing like this. Which I've been kind of regretting because I started having more and more pain in my wrists and I just feel like I could not type properly without looking at my keyboard. So I decided to learn how to properly touch type again. So what are some of the reasons of why I want to learn how to type with all my fingers? First of all, wrist pain. I've been having more and more, like the more that I do work on my PC, the more I realize that I'm actually not doing a good posture, causing pain in my arms, fingers, hands. It's uncomfortable after some time. Another reason is also because I want to type more efficiently without having to look at my keys the whole time because of my fingers wandering off to a different position and me pressing the wrong keys the whole time. And something that is not a reason for me of like what I want to achieve, and that is I don't want to learn how to type quickly. I just want to reach the same amount of words per minute as I do right now, which is around 80, 83. I don't care about typing fast or typing as much as possible within a minute. I just want to type more efficiently, not having to look at my keys the whole time, of my fingers wandering, that's it. But you might be wondering, why not switch to a different layout? Well, I actually switched to a different layout in the beginning. I'm using QWERTY now, but I'm from Belgium, we use AZERTY. When I switched to QWERTY, that took a little bit of getting used to, but worked quite well. But now I type in both English and Japanese. And for that, I feel QWERTY is probably the better way. Like, you have things like Dvorak and Coleman and such. Workman, I'll probably stick with QWERTY. It's too convenient and I'm too used to it. And I don't want to have an entire month of learning whilst decreasing the progress that I want to make. I want to type more efficiently, and switching to different layouts won't give me any benefits in the short run. So let's do a quick typing test on how I type now. Let's see how that goes. So like usual, around 83, and let's try to do a typing test, trying to use my 10 fingers and trying to keep them on the home row. Let's see how that goes. Probably not 83. Let's try that one more time. Okay, so I think it's obvious that I cannot really touch type. The main websites that I was using to practice my typing was KBR and MonkeyType. I was not really getting anywhere the first 2 days, but from the third day I had almost 50 words per minute. The day after that, kind of the same, and then I finally reached the 51 mark, so I gave myself around 1 week to practice and improve. Okay, so it's day 3 and I did a couple of changes. First of all, I turned off the RGB on my keyboard, so I will stop hopefully looking at my keyboard the entire time. Also, the palm rest, I removed it because apparently when you're typing, you're supposed to hold your hands in the air and not rest them on anything. That also helps against pain. It's different to type like this. It's really getting used to. And the whole way that the keyboard is laid out, because they're not in a column, they're kind of like sideways. This is quite annoying because the B I will often press with my right hand and not my left hand. And yeah, I have not really tried programming yet because the last couple of days I've been kind of busy. So I don't really know how I will use all the other buttons because right now I already kind of struggle with this. Let's practice some more. And on monkey type, I started getting almost 50, and it kept going around 50 until I finally reached 60. Something that I also noticed was the amount of mistakes I made became a lot less. My accuracy was a lot higher compared to my previous way of typing. So, how did it go? Well, first of all, I had two goals that I wanted to achieve. First, my wrist pain. My wrist pain became less, but not zero. And the next goal was to become more efficient. The more I started trying to test type correctly, the more I found the staggered layout of the keyboard to be kind of annoying. And especially when programming, having to reach these keys here and this key, the delete key, it was annoying. It was really annoying. And then I started looking more into split keyboards. Part two of this keyboard series will come. But overall, I think my efficiency improved. I could type a lot faster on this keyboard. And I honestly recommend it to everybody. If you struggle with typing blindly and or just want to become more efficient in typing and getting text on the screen, learn how to touch type correctly. It really doesn't take that long. And before I was like before I was like at 30 words per minute, but I very easily got it up to a higher amount because I had been using a keyboard for a long time already, so I kind of knew the average location of each single key. But yeah, I like this keyboard, but I'm kind of glad that I switched over to the new one. And honestly, now after having used this split keyboard for some time, going back to a normal keyboard frustrates me a lot. Your thumbs on this kind of a keyboard are basically useless. But that's for the next video, for part two. But yeah, I really do recommend trying to learn how to touch type correctly. It saves you a lot of time. It's more efficient to type as well. If you'll be faster than typing like that, no idea. I just found my accuracy, and that was a big one. I did not think that my accuracy will be so high. The amount of times that I reached 98 were quite low. Most of the time I hit 100, which I did not really expect. So yeah, test typing recommended. And let me know, how do you type? Do you plan on learning how to type more properly, or are you just fine the way you're typing right now? Anyway, it's very late right now. There are construction works going on recently, so filming videos is becoming a night job. Skataganai. See you all in the next one. Good luck typing. Oh. I hope I didn't scratch my glass.